scuffles erupt in Jerusalem as Israeli protesters take to the streets for a second day, demanding the release of the remaining hostages in Gaza. The recovery over the weekend of six hostages said to have been shot 48 to 72 hours before their bodies were found by Israeli forces triggered a wave of grief and fury in Israel. At least 500,000 took to the streets and on Sunday. They were joined Monday by Israel's largest trade union, which launched a general strike to press government to reach a deal with Hamas. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu rejecting calls to soften his demand to keep troops in the southern Gazan border as the price for a ceasefire deal. The so-called Philadelphia Corridor has been a major sticking point in efforts to secure a deal to halt the fighting and return Israeli hostages. Hamas has rejected any Israeli presence, while Netanyahu has insisted that Israel will not abandon the corridor, where Israeli troops have uncovered dozens of tunnels they say have been used to smuggle weapons and ammunition into Gaza.
The axis of evil needs the Philadelphia corridor, and for that reason, we must control the Philadelphia corridor. Hamas insists for that reason that we not be there, and for that reason, I insist that we be there. Presence in the Philadelphia corridor is first and foremost a political strategic issue. We must set firm the fact that we are there.
U.S. President Joe Biden says he is close to presenting a final proposal for a deal to release hostages held by Hamas. While he remains optimistic, Biden also says Netanyahu was not doing enough to secure such an agreement. The Israeli leader's stance on the negotiations, which have been continuing for weeks while showing little sign of a breakthrough, has frustrated allies, including the U.S., and widened a rift with his own defense minister.
Mr. President, do you think it's time for Prime Minister Netanyahu to do more on this issue? Do you think he's doing enough?
No.
Do you have a message for the hostages' family, sir?
Yes, I've spoken to the American hostage. I spoke to his mom and dad, and we're not giving up. We're going to continue to push as hard as we can.
Thank you.
Asked about Biden's comments, Netanyahu insists pressure should be applied to Hamas, adding anyone who is serious about achieving peace would not ask Israel to make more concessions. Brazil's Supreme Court votes to uphold the suspension of social media giant X in the country. Last week, a Supreme Court justice ruled X should be suspended in Brazil because it did not name a local legal representative as required by law. Four other justices agreed, with three of them saying the suspension could be reversed if the platform complied with previous rulings. X was taken down in Brazil in the early hours of Saturday after the decision. Brazil is the sixth biggest market globally of X, with more than 20 million users. Now let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, TJ Manotok.
Good morning to friends at The Rundown. Here are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region.
As we get to know a Florida program that helps newly arrived Filipino teachers adjust to life in America. To address the teacher shortage in Florida, several school districts have recruited teachers directly from the Philippines through the J-1 visa program. The group Jacks Filipinos in Florida recently launched the Balik Escuela program to provide support and resources to these newly arrived educators. The program offers then essential items such as school supplies and connects them with local communities.
We thought of the idea of bringing school supplies. You know, when they come to a new classroom, they need to set up their classroom. So it's just one thing to provide for them so that it's something to ease their mind.
It's like a fellowship with our co-Filipino teachers. And another one is yung mga supplies na dinonate, which is sobrang na-appreciate po talaga ng mga namin, ng mga Filipino teachers. It's malaking help po siya sa mga teachers, lalo na po dun sa mga kakadating lang.
And finally, we meet a Filipino-Canadian who became a mentor to breakdancer Philip Kim, the gold medalist in the Olympics' first breaking competition this year. Filipino-Canadian Jerry Quizon, one of the first B-boys of Vancouver, is the former coach of Olympic breaking gold medalist Philip Kim, or Phil Wizard. Quizon said the young Kim first saw the group called the Now or Never Crew, a local breaking crew in Vancouver, and this sparked the boy's interest in breaking.
He was about 10, 11 years old. and, you know, kind of witness him growing up to now being an Olympic breaking champion.
Kim also trained in his own Boogaloo Dance Academy. The hip-hop coach beamed with pride when Kim won the gold.
Well, yeah, it's very exciting for me and a lot of the Canadian dancers in general. I think we're all, like, you know, happy that he won.
His owner is also set to rename the studio to Phil Wizard Studio in honor of Kim.
And those are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region. You can catch more of our TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website and YouTube channel. I'm TJ Manotok. Back to our friends at the Rundown.